कर्मा, कर्मन इज सिंगुलर फॉर कर्मा प्लूरल, कर्मन माने एक सिंगल एक्ट, मिस्टर एक्स मर्डर्ड मिस्टर वाई एज अ सिंगल एक्ट इट इज कर्मन, ही इज अ मर्डरर मतलब कईयों को मारा है, ही हैज बीन मर्डरिंग फॉर मेनी लाइव्स एंड ही हैज डन दिस एंड ही हैज डन दिस एंड ही हैज डन दिस, ऑल दैट क्राइम पुट टुगेदर इज कर्म. बट कर्म इज नॉट ऑलवेज नेगेटिव, देयर इज गुड एक्ट्स ऑल्सो, सो कर्म इज अ प्लूरल थिंग इंडिकेटिंग मेनी बहुत बहु. ऑल एक्ट्स और एक्शंस परफॉर्म बाय द बॉडी माइंड और सोल, थ्री इन्वॉल्वमेंट इज देयर फॉर कर्म. यू कैन हैव बॉडी कर्म, यू कैन हैव माइंड कर्म और यू कैन हैव सोल कर्म. प्लीज कीप दिस इन माइंड, दीज आर थिंग्स यू हैव टू थिंक अबाउट, यू विल नॉट अंडरस्टैंड इट फुल्ली अनलेस यू थिंक अबाउट इट. यू हैव बॉडी कर्म, यू हैव माइंड कर्म एंड यू हैव सोल कर्म, थ्री फैक्टर्स. एनी रिलीजियस एक्ट और राइट एज सैक्रीफाइस ओब्लेशन, सैक्रीफाइस मीन्स यज्ञ, यज्ञ इज ट्रांसलेशन दे कॉल फायर सैक्रीफाइस, पूजा सैक्रीफाइस. सी इंग्लिश डज नॉट हैव एन इक्विवेलेंट वर्ड, रिचुअल प्रेयर शुड हैव बीन अ बेटर ट्रांसलेशन. पूजा इज रिचुअल प्रेयर ऑफरिंग्स, सो सैक्रीफाइस, फायर सैक्रीफाइस, बलि, गॉड नोज दे डोंट हैव वर्ड्स. सो इट इज बेटर फॉर अस टू नो दैट वी शुड लर्न द संस्कृत वर्ड्स इफ वी डोंट हैव अ वर्ड इन द इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज. यज्ञ पूजा, ओब्लेशन अभिषेक, एज ओरिजिनेटिंग इन द होप ऑफ फ्यूचर रिकम्पेंस एंड एज अपोज टू स्पेकुलेटिव रिलीजन और नॉलेज ऑफ स्पिरिट. When you are doing a puja or when you are doing a abhishek or when you are doing a ritual or when you are doing jap, you are not speculating, is there God or there is no God? Is the human body having a spirit or it is not having a spirit? What is the nature of the atma? It is white or it is black? What is the nature? There is no speculation. It is an action you are doing. Why are you doing this action? With a prayer. A prayer that you may be forgiven for your sins, that may others with whom you have created this karma, may they also have peace. Let's say Mr. X has murdered Mr. Y. Simultaneously karma is created for both. So in next life Mr. Y will be given opportunity to kill Mr. X. So both have got karma. So just because X has murdered Y, Y should simultaneously forgive X. Then what happens is, at least Y is taken out from the cycle and X will have to suffer his part. If X prays for forgiveness, then he is releasing Y also. You see, karma is not just, it may be created by an individual soul or an individual soul in the sense of an individual soul. But the fact is that it always involves multiple. If you are sitting here and I am playing the role of a teacher and you are playing the role of a student, maybe I have karma associated with teaching and learning. You may have got the good fortune. Let us say we all went to one school in our last life and I was the favorite of the teacher. I quietly learnt everything from him, promising him that, oh, I will teach the others, don't worry, I will take care. I didn't bother to teach you fellows. So in this life I will have to teach it. So I could be doing that. So you see, the karma can manifest in many different ways, depending upon how it was created in the first place. And also good karma you are doing a prayer or a puja, visiting a temple, helping a sick man, you can create good karmas. So actions consisting in motion as the third among the seven categories of Nyaya philosophy. Any action that you do, there must be a motion involved, a movement. Movement is caused by Vayu. Please note, movement or motion is called by Vayu. There could be a motion in your mind. Some movement is there. You could think that you are traveling, sitting in an aircraft and traveling somewhere, or you are lifting something and drinking something. You are thinking about it. when you are thinking that you are lifting a glass of water and drinking, Vayu Tattva is activated. Otherwise, how did the glass move? Okay. Because Vayu Tattva got activated in your mind, there was some Agni in your mind, which it burnt. It's like fire and air. And because the fire burnt, because of the Vayu, therefore you saw the picture. So all action must have movement involved. Must. There must be Vayu involved in the action. And Vayu is ruled by which planet? Saturn. We come back to Shani Maharaj. So you see, it is this movement or the motion which is causing that karma. So karma, we can say, is largely associated with Saturn, whether it is in the form of action or it is in the form of motion. The sense organs, jnanendriyas, actions of thought, manasa karma. So thought is happening because of the sense organs, jnanendriya. You are getting some knowledge, some information. That information is producing thought. When you touch something hot, you take your hand away because it created a thought that my hand will get burnt, and that thought caused you to take your hand away. So karma was done not just by your hand, it was also done by your mind. Okay, so then there are the action organs called karmendriya. Together they cause speech, which is vachika karma. So firstly, you have manasa karma, or karma of the mind. Then you have sharirika karma, karma of the body. Like eating food is the karma of the body. And then you have vachika karma. Vachi means speech. Speech is associated with the soul. Vachika karma is done by the soul, the atma. So what is the way to control the karma associated with the soul? Mauna vrata. Vachika karma is controlled by mauna vrata, the vow of silence. Mauna vrata should be practiced at the time of meditation. That means when you are meditating, you must not be speaking. You and I cannot be having discussions and then also meditating. It is the mauna, the silence, the perfect silence, which is the upasana or the penance, the tapas of the soul. Sharirika karma has to do with the body. So many actions are done by the body. Then there is manasa karma, thoughts. Fate, as a certain consequence of acts in the past, your bhagya or your fate or your destiny, predestiny, is based upon previous karmas of the past. Now, the word karma is also associated with work relating to making a living. If, for example, you have to prepare sweets to make a living, that is also called karma. It is karma of the past life that forces you to do karma in this life. But a sadhu, a one who has renounced this world, is not going to be associated with karma associated with a living. They cannot. If they are making a living, they are not sadhu. So there are certain conditions I have given over here. 10th nakshatra called the manasa nakshatra. See, karma in the mind is created through the nakshatras. Karma in the body is created through the rashis. And vachika karma comes from beyond that. Work related to making a living is in the 10th nakshatra, manasa, the 10th bhava, which is the body karma. Then there is a performance and business, there are career, vocations, office, special duties, occupations, oblations, and so many things that can be listed under karma. Brihaspati Niji says a very beautiful thing. Auspicious signs, characteristic marks are of no avail when karma manifests to clash. Sri Rama had stout muscular calves, Lakshmana was as swift as sound, and Sita had thickly grown glossy hair. This is all signs of very good karma. Rama's hand is so famous, his hand was so long that it crossed the legs. What is it called?
Ajanulambita Vahu.
Lakshana. Lakshanas of the body. He had all the marks in his feet. But what fate he suffered? So what is Brihaspati trying to tell us? That means the whole science of studying marks on the body, he is laughing at that science. Do you see that? Why? Because Narada Muni, Narada Purana has got, if the lady has got eyes like this and this thing, that thing, it'll have this. Brihaspati laughs at all that. He says, nonsense. Somebody may be very good looking but still have a terrible fate. Somebody may be bad looking but have a very good fate. Looks and fate are separate. It is all karma that is manifesting. If the karma that is manifesting is clashing with your looks, then it is the looks which you'll have to bow, because karma will not bow to anyone. Do you see Brihaspati's wisdom? Okay. Three categories. Karma is having three categories. Okay. First and foremost, and the most important word that we are concerned with is Sanchita Karma. छोड़ दो उसको, छोड़ दे, जो अपने आप करेगा. संचित कर्म. व्हाट इज संचित कर्म? इट इज एक्यूमुलेटेड कर्म बैलेंस. फ्रैंकली देर आर सम वेज इन विच वी मे ट्राई टू फाइंड आउट व्हाट इज संचित कर्म, बट देर इज नो वे वी कैन फाइंड आउट व्हाट इज संचित कर्म, बिकॉज संचित कर्म इज लाइक अ माउंटेन. ठीक है ना? It is a bank balance. Net, it is the net. Sanchita means piled together, heaped up, gathered, collected, accumulated. The measure of such karma is a rashi. So the word rashi is a heap. People always used to wonder, what is this heaped up? Why the word rashi is used? It is karma heap. Sanchita karma is a heap of karma. So the heap of karma is in the rashis. The Rashi is nothing but a measure of the Sanchita Karma. It is the word is the same. The Rashi is signifying Sanchita Karma. It is a heap of karma. So now you have a completely different view of the word Rashi. Earlier you thought Rashi is a heap, but why should it be heap? Why not plain? But now you are clear that it is karma heap. How big and how tall the karma heap is, we don't know. There must be ways to calculate it. The measure of such karma is a rashi, a zodiacal sign. And the word rashi also means a heap or pile, from where everything is given by the Adityas. So who created this heap? Adityas created this heap. So the heap of karma that is created in the 12 Rashis has been created by the Adityas. And that heap has been taken from Sanchita Karma. So from Sanchita Karma, they took little handfuls and put it in each of the 12 Rashis, by which these 12 Rashis were created. So the 12 Rashis were created by whom? They created by the sun, Surya Dev. Surya Dev, therefore, based upon the Atma that is to incarnate, has created these heaps for the Atma. He is going around the zodiac and creating the heaps of karma. He is putting those heaps, and then when the heaps are ready for the soul to incarnate, it is incarnating. Okay. Prarabdha karma. Prarabdha karma is defined as the fruit bearing karma. It is the portion of Sanchita karma that has ripened and appears as an experience in the present incarnation. So Rashi is more specifically Prarabdha Karma and not Sanchita Karma. Because Sanchita Karma is much bigger than the Rashi. Let us say I give a figure, just any figure. Let us say 100 for Sanchita Karma. Okay? From 100, they took Prarabdha Karma, let us say 10, or say 12 Prarabdha Karma, to create this incarnation. So how much is left? 88 is left. So that 88 is still lying somewhere in your record, in the cosmic records. In this life, you have made a contract to deal with 12 Prarabdha Karma. So they took one Prarabdha Karma and they put it in the 12 Rashis. So therefore the Rashi, as far as this incarnation is concerned, has to do with the Prarabdha Karma. So Prarabdha Karma is a portion of the bank balance of Sanchita Karma. It is not the full withdrawal. You have not withdrawn the full quantity. But some quantity has been taken which you can deal with. It is like having lot of work, but you cannot do all the work, so you have taken a portion of the work which you can deal with. And in this incarnation, you are dealing with that portion of the work. And that portion of the work is being manifested as the Rashi, 12 Rashi. It is impossible to experience and endure all karma in one life. From Sanchita Karma balance, a handful is taken out to serve one lifetime, which forms Jataka or the horoscope at birth and is the karmic contract. So you have a contract with Kala, that is time personified as the Kala Purusha. Kala is above Trimurti. Kala is above Brahma, above Vishnu, above Rudra. Kala is right on top. He is time. And based upon his power, even the Trimurti have to incarnate. So, based upon that Kala, for a certain Kala, certain period of time, you have made a contract to experience a portion of your Sanchita Karma, which is called Prarabdha Karma. So when you make a horoscope, a Jataka, it is only for Prarabdha Karma. You cannot see Sanchita Karma from there, can you? No. Contract starts from the union. It is called the Nisheka Lagna or conception, which is the Adhana Jataka, and bears fruit based on time and is to be experienced, Anubhava. The only way this can be annulled, spent, is through Anubhava, through experiencing it. Okay? So therefore, a Jataka, and when does this contract start? From the moment of Nisheka, when the Adhana occurs. When the Adhana occurs, the experience of the karma begins. To experience the karmas, your indriyas have to be developed. The more developed your indriyas are, the more highly developed your karmendriya and jnanendriya is, the more powerful is the karma experience. If the indriyas are not well developed, the karma experience is low. So you can say that the karma experience for lesser animals is much lesser than that of human beings. Though the soul may not be less, but the Sanchita, but the Prarabdha Karma in the chart is much less. Because all their indriyas are not working with that wisdom, that much wisdom, or that much experience, or that much understanding as that of Manushya Jataka. So the Jataka, the horoscope at birth, is the limited list of one's past karma, all actions good and bad that are from past incarnations. and that is limited to the prarabdha which you have contracted to experience in this life. Therefore, life is nothing but a contract. It's a contract between you and God as kala, time. And that kala form of God is called kala purusha. Om kalaya namah, om kala purushaya namah. So basically, we are worshipping kala, time, and kala purusha, the personification of time, as God or om. And why are we doing so? Because for He is the one who is with whom we have signed the contract. And we have to fulfill this contract. He is going to be the witness. Time is the witness to everything. Then the third one is called Kriyamana Karma. Kriya, you know, is action. Mana, karma. All karma of the present incarnation. After you are born, you have a jataka. That jataka, at the moment of birth, has to do with everything till that point of time. Therefore, that is prarabdha karma. But from the time you are born, you are again doing some karmas. You are thinking, you are eating, you are drinking, you are going to school, you are interacting. So you are creating karmas. And all the karmas that you create from the point of birth till now is kriyamana karma. This is new karma. This is not a part of sanchita karma. It is adding to the sanchita karma. This can be studied from what we call the prashna chart. A prashna chart sincerely drawn for the moment of the query can be compared to the birth chart to tell us whether we have added more negative karma or we have removed negative karma, whether we have added more positive karma or we have removed positive karma. The concept that by doing positive karma I am removing negative karma need not be true all the time. The karmas may not be interlinked the way you think, that every karma is interlinked. It is in a manner. Time interlinks everything. But it is not a direct correlation. For example, a person tends to overeat food. He is greedy and he overeats the food. So he has some karma, let us say, related to overeating of the food. This may have or no connection at all with his karma related to work. He can say that by overeating the food, I am feeling sleepy, that is why I cannot work. But that is his mind which is playing the tricks with him. The work karma has to do with his wanting to, his doing the work and not doing the work. Let us say like going to office or like serving someone, that is his work karma. So just because he ate the food, he cannot go to work, so food has become bad karma for work. No, such things, it does not work like that. It may not be interlinked. You may do some bad karma towards your brother and expect that, okay, if I go to, let us say, my mother and give her some money, my bad karma to my brother is cleared. No, it is not so. That is karma with your mother and this is karma with your brother. They are completely different. One is bad and one is good and both will go into separate accounts and separate bank balances. They have separate balances for everything. To annul a karma, Jyotish teaches that how we can negate or remove negative karma by finding that karma which is of a similar color, which is of a similar vibration. If I have negative karma pertaining to a wife in my last birth, and in this birth, let us say, I do good karma for women, that can negate the bad karma that I have done. Because that is interlinked. Because the karma was related to Shukra. We call it Shukra karma. So in Jyotish, what we will be doing is we will take these grahas as the 9 factors of karma. The grahas are the 9 factors of karma. You must bear that in mind. And these 9 factors are independent bank balances within a major bank balance. And these grahas, that is why the word is graha, grahana, to eclipse. They have the power to eclipse you to keep you in darkness and to compel you and force you to do things. That is the Grahana Kala, the experience of the Grahana. You are born into Grahana and you will die in Grahana. You are born into an eclipse, you will die in an eclipse. That is the truth of your life, because you are born into karmas and you will die with the karmas. And these karmas are being manifesting. The experience of the karma is because of the grahas. But till now, we know that there are only three agencies for karma. What are the three agencies? Manas karma, sharira karma, and vachika karma. Manasa karma is for the manas, that is the mind. Sharirika karma is sharira, that is the body. Vachika karma is vach, the speech, which created everything. That is the creator. Who created everything? Surya created everything. And Surya is the soul of all. That is why vachika karma is related to soul. Because all creation has come from sound. If all creation did not come from sound, vachika karma cannot be related to the soul. So now we are realizing that the karma balance, to study karma balance, so there is a thing called Sanchita Karma, which is a concept to which we may have mathematical calculations, but there can be no definite means of finding out. It is not possible. The rishis, the Trikalagyas, they can know. But that is a very deep meditation you will require, and that level of spiritual depth to understand. Prarabdha karma, yes, as a Jyotish, you should be able to learn and understand, because that will show in the chart. Kriyamana karma, the karma which has been created from the birth till this point through Prashna. So, let us understand a very clear thing. When somebody comes to you for a horoscope reading or for a Jyotish consultation, you have to make a Prashna chart. Without a Prashna chart, there is no means in your hand to know what is the Kriyamana Karma. Do not blindly only rely on Prarabdha Karma manifestation. Because Prarabdha Karma is manifesting to the Jataka, to the horoscope. And you cannot blindly only rely on the horoscope for manifestation of all the experiences. In this life also you have done some karma, and there will be some manifestation of some of this karma in this life itself. Which means that because of the karma that you have created, Kala is simultaneously modifying your contract. Or your contract with Kala Purusha has got certain clauses of modification, which allows the contract to be modified based upon the karma, Kriyamana karma, that you do in this life. That tells us a very important thing. If there is something called Kriyamana karma, we have an option of doing such Kriyamana karma by which we can modify our original contract, by which we can prevent the experience of bad karmas, by which we can annul the experience of bad karmas. And that is called Vedic remedies. And that is how Vedic remedies work. By a modification of the original contract of the Jataka or the Prarabdha Karma. Through Kriyamana Karma. Are we clear on this? So now you know how the whole system works. Also you know now that there are three agencies through which all the karma is being created. The Sharirika, Manasika and the Vachika. But there are nine grahas. How is it that these three agencies are mapping into the nine grahas should be our next modus of study. Let us go one step further.